Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. Luke 23, verse 34. Several years ago, I went on a pilgrimage to Northern Ireland, and I found myself in Derry, or Londonderry, a place so divided that people can't even agree on what it's called. And I visited the place on the Bogside where, in January 1972, 4 months before I was born, a peaceful protest against unlawful internment turned into a riot, and British soldiers shot 26 civilians, 14 of whom died. And on that day, I visited the place where these awful events happened, and spoke later with people from both sides of the community, unionists and Republicans. It was an incredibly sad day. And one of the saddest things was that as I met and listened to people from each side of that divided community, those born more recently, over 30 years after the events of that day, seemed to be the most passionate. They were the ones who seemed most wounded, who seemed to have the freshest hurts. They were the ones, if I'm honest, who exhibited most hate towards the others. And as I listened to them, I was forced to admit that each side had, it seemed, perfect logic in their argument. They were not irrational people. If anything, they were too rational. There was a chain of events that led from that awful day, 49 years ago, right up to the present day. And as I reflected on that experience, I asked myself, what is there that can break these chains? What is there that can end the cycle of condemnation? What is there that can interrupt the endless need for retribution and revenge? In a word, forgiveness. Forgiveness is the letting go of past hurts. Forgiveness is not fair. Forgiveness is not, strictly speaking, logical. Forgiveness is separate from the sometimes necessary seeking of reparation. And in these days where the longing for justice, especially against oppressed and abused minorities, is so strong, and rightly so, we need to hold on also to the sheer power of forgiveness. On the cross, Jesus, the only person who's ever lived who did not himself need to be forgiven, offered forgiveness to his executioners. Moments after they had driven iron spikes through the most pain-sensitive areas of his body, he prayed, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing." Jesus made a way for us to be forgiven without sidestepping the need for justice, for reparation. He died for our sins. The punishment that was upon him has brought us peace. He who did not need to be forgiven has offered forgiveness for all people for all time by making the perfect sacrifice for sin through his body on the cross. Jesus showed us that it is possible to forgive others even while they are causing us great pain. So let us come to the cross today. Let us bring with us our sins, all of the ways in which we feel guilty or ashamed and know we need forgiveness. And let us, with our other hand, bring to the cross those who have hurt us, maybe a long time ago, maybe today. And let us remember Jesus' words, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they're doing." And let us pray as he taught us, "Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us." Lord Jesus, thank you for the cross. Amen.